Hello， 观众朋友们，大家好，我是主持人 Emily。那么我们今天的嘉宾可能是你们比较熟悉的，来自破产姐妹的 Matthew Moy。Hi, Matthew Moy. Thank you so much for joining us.
I'm happy to be here.
Thank you. Thank you. Before we get started, what do you have going on in your background? Your room looks like a dream.
Wait, first of all, do you hear my cat? This is so funny. You want to see my cat? My cat is already meowing. He meowed on cue. Okay, so I just got a spin bike. We'll talk about that later, but I love to have lights on. I kind of got bored during quarantine, and my room is a rave party right now. I mean, check it out. Check out the party.
So you've been keeping yourself pretty busy during quarantine, huh?
Yeah, you know, I've been doing all sorts of things. This is really a time, I mean, for those of us who are healthy, and, you know, keeping safe inside, it's really a time for self-care, you know? Mm-hmm. Now's the time to explore all the things you've wanted to learn or do. Yeah. I'm sorry about my cat.
Let's just start with, you know, some positives. You know, what are some new hobbies that maybe you picked up? What new discoveries have you learned about yourself? For instance, I learned that I just can't cook.
Which is another thing. I'm a little rusty on cooking. Like the other day I made biscuits. I was like, oh, these are going to be great. They were terrible. I'm like, man, spinning. I thought I could just relax and lay back on my couch and be like, yeah, I'll eat healthy. I'll be fine. And I was like, man, I miss working out. So that's, I got a cheapo spin bike, turn on the music, pump the lights, and we're good.
Your room actually looks a lot like a soul cycle classroom without the crazy instructor screaming at you. Yes.
Well, I've also been painting. You know, I like to paint. And one thing I did, probably what you were shifting to, was I got really concerned during the crisis, right when it started, because my aunt works at a big nursing home in San Francisco. She works at Laguna Honda. I wanted to help her out, so I started donating masks, first to San Francisco, and then I was like, you know, why don't I start collecting stuff for LA? And then that became a whole thing, and that I realized people cope with this pandemic in different ways, right? Some people want to sit on the couch, relax, that's fine. But for me, that makes me feel better is helping other people. I know it sounds really altruistic, be like, Matt, you're such a... But it makes me feel like less anxious that I'm helping them stay safe, you know? Yeah. So I did this whole mask donation thing, which is really cool. And yeah, that took up like 3 weeks of my life, so kept me very focused.
I mean, you didn't just donate like a couple. You donated 2,500 masks. A lot of mask suppliers actually jacked their prices up.
Yeah.
So for people like us who are just trying to do something good, it's like we don't have, you know, millions and millions of dollars just lying around to buy these masks, right? So, you know, we're buying them at a pretty hefty price and we're just donating them to people. Like it's actually a pretty pricey act of kindness.
Oh, yeah, totally. And it was so amazing to see the response when I went to those hospitals, because they usually expect their donations to come in from big commercial companies. Their brains sort of short-circuited in a good way. They're like, "What? Who do you work for? Where is this from?" I was like, oh, no, this is just my own personal supply that, you know, I went out and got for some different places. And, you know, here it's for you guys. And they appreciated it so much. I even had to donate to some grocery stores because they were like, we don't have them. We don't have them by the mandate because everybody was waiting for the shipments, which was crazy.
What do you think I could do from home to help out?
Well, first, you don't need to help out. That's the first thing I'll say. I mean, it's everybody's own prerogative what they want to do. Like I said, everybody copes in different ways. I think the most important thing to do during this time while we're all stuck at home is to stay emotionally sane. I think that, and to stay emotionally balanced and not to have any emotional dis-ease, because I think that can make people spin into chaos really quickly. And it's kind of like idle hands. You get kind of bored and then, you know, and then they start going on these political rants or all these self-isolation rants and be like, oh, let us out, you know, government, let us out. And I think the most important thing to do is stay emotionally sane. But if you want to help out, I think that's great.
Would you recommend people do to stay sane?
Man, whatever makes you feel better. And that could be through working out, you know, doing push-up challenges, to Zooming with friends, to painting. I know a lot of friends who are taking up painting and drawing right now, which I love. I always respond to them, oh man, I'm going to take you to painting class. Or, you know, donating masks. Oh, that's what I was going to say. The first thing I did after the mask donation thing sparked was I donated to families and friends. I made sure all my family members were safe and had masks, and all my friends, you know, just little things like that. Knowing that my group of core people was safe and protected, I was like, that makes me feel a lot better, you right? know? I do have some friends, though, who got COVID during the crisis, and it's scary, you know?
Yeah.
This one friend was saying, she was like, oh my God, I got, because her parents got it, then she got it. She was like, we were taken out of commission so bad, but we're better now. And she was like, trust me, you do not want it. COVID doesn't really ignore anybody, children, young or old. And that's why I don't want to really take my chances too much with going out, just because who knows what it can do to your body, you know?
When was the last time you actually stepped out the door? And what was it for?
Taking out the trash. That was just the other day. Got to do that. And I have to go out to get groceries sometimes. But I'm so thankful that I was able to get groceries right before the shutdown happened. Costco was so crazy a week before the shutdown. Oh my God. But I got it. So, but yeah, I don't go out of the house too often.
What is your biggest regret in terms of something that you wish you did before the lockdown?
You see how long my hair is getting? I wish I had gotten a haircut right before lockdown. I wish I had gone to Costco to get toilet paper a week before lockdown.
You know, I think the last question, which is kind of the core of this chat, is how has COVID affected your industry? Well, yeah. Hollywood's been, you know, greatly affected. What's it going to be like when you go back?
Who knows? That's a good question. What's the world going to be like when everything starts up again? You know, what shops are going to be open? What's going to be still be closed? Hollywood is pretty much 90% shut down. Luckily, as an actor, I'm really used to having sporadic times of working and not working. That's, you know, the nature of our jobs. Luckily, I'm also a voice actor too. So voiceover auditions, still going strong. I haven't worked on a job yet, but I've got a little home studio set up, which is nice. So I have the ability to record if I get hired. I've also been working on my home studio setup to make it nicer and more professional these past few weeks. So that's been driving me bonkers, but still a great experience. But yeah, I don't know what's going to happen with pilot season, all those pilots. Mm-hmm. Everything was put on hold. What shows are going to survive? What's not? It's everything's the Wild West, and I think we're going to have to figure it all out. I mean, you know, TV productions, movie productions, they spend millions of dollars on these things. My favorite buffet, Soup Plantation, just closed.
I heard.
Who knows how buffets are going to be like after this? I love buffets.
Me too. I
want them to close.
Everything should be a buffet. Have you reached out to your co-stars during these times?
Yeah, I just spoke to Kat the other day. You know, Kat just started gardening a month ago, and her plants are doing amazing. And I'm just thinking, man, I should do that too. How self-sufficient is that?
Right.
I haven't talked to too many of them, though, but we still keep in touch over the years. You know, Garrett and I, we kept missing each other right before the quarantine because we wanted to have lunch, but then quarantine happened. But he's probably the one I see the most still. How are you, Emily? You doing good?
I am. And I just want to say, yeah. I'm more than happy to talk about me. Yeah, but in terms of the interview, you are done.
Good to see you guys.